Hi, and welcome back. A long time ago, Lockmania was struggling each Saturday to get a Habo oval cylinder open. It's actually one of those Ruko clones that share the same VT profile as the open Ruko 6-pin. And that's what the key looked like. Some extremely nasty overset trap there on pin 5 from the tip. And we can see here we have a no cut here on pin 3, and it's just really hard to get around that overset trap to set this pin. So it took him a good length of time to get this open, and we talked about that maybe someone else should have a chance to try their luck on this nasty key. So as I'm doing the Christmas care package for Lockmania, I thought maybe this would be the time to actually get on with the project, and so that I can get this one back to him. And to not make this too costly, I found a pile of these YaSafe industrial cylinders for letterboxes, and I just took a key blank and a shim and popped them open, and then I took some cheap JMA blanks and cut some 5 keys, like his Habo key. And I've laid out some pins here that I'm gonna populate this cylinder, and then I'm gonna make 4 extra when off cam, and then I'm gonna dump these in the box and hopefully get it on the way over to Jutland, so Lockmania can have some fun for his Christmas series. And the plan here is actually that these can be sent out to people around the world who want to give this nasty key and corresponding cylinder a try, and then you can pass it on to someone else, and let's see how quickly we can actually get this nasty thing picked on cam and have some nice purpose for 2021. And let's see what we can get out of this little Habo project. All the pins are just from my scrap pin bucket, so some of them are gonna maybe be with brass key pins, and some are being regular Ruko Asa pins, and some are gonna be these YaSafe with a slight taper on the top, so they're just gonna be mixed up. I think the key bidding is enough to make this a challenge anyway, so it's not that important exactly what pins go in, but I'm just gonna mix them up, and then we'll see what happens. So if I remember, I'll put a link to Lockmania's channel in the description below, and then go check out his ongoing yearly Christmas series, where he's gonna pick a lock for his advent calendar, so like one new cylinder every day to count down to Christmas Eve, which is on the 24th here in Denmark. We do not feel the need to wait all the way into to midnight and the 25th, so we celebrate our Christmas on the 24th. So yeah, now we have some activity for the time being. I'm just gonna use my front loader here, because then we don't need to have pins flying everywhere in the attempt to get them in the Bible. So I'm just gonna load these. They are different length, as we are using a balanced pin stack that is extra important in these industrial ones, because if you just put random pins in, there's no way you can get the key out again. So now where did you go, you little? Come back here. You're going in. You're gonna be part of this No, escaping now. And I'll just have a quick look off cam to see that all chambers are populated, and they are. So we just gotta slide this back, and then I only so far only put the springs in, so they are in here. So now we're gonna join these two if we can get this onto the follower, and then we're gonna slide it in, push it all the way in, rotate it to 12 o'clock, push this part in so it actually loads all, and then we're gonna separate these two, and now we have the biped populated, and then we take the core and hopefully we can get this in. Works perfectly good. Then as this is a letterbox lock and we want it to rotate clockwise, so we're gonna take one of these 90 degree limiter and we're gonna put it in this way so that we can turn it clockwise, and then we're gonna take one of these little springs if they wanna cooperate. Come on, you little devil. You can't hide in there. I'm gonna get you anyway, so give up. Come here. Ah, dang it. I'm just gonna take his brother then. Nope. You aren't gonna escape me. Come here. Ugh. Need different tweezers. I couldn't be bothered to go and get the other tweezers, so I thought I'd just do with what I had on the table. That was maybe a mistake. Oh well. Guess that's the joy of making video. You just get to get all the problems. I'm gonna have one of these retaining pins and dump that in as well. And then we're gonna take one of these. It's actually to get the distance right, because otherwise you can't clamp it down. So that's why I'm putting the cam on it. And as I don't have my magic follower here with the tailpiece cap device, so I'm just gonna see if I can use the tip of my tweezers for this. And as this is not Ruko, the tread on this plug is really terrible, but yeah, you get what you pay for, and this wasn't expensive at any point, so there we go. One big challenge for some lucky person somewhere in the world. So yeah, just want to say good luck, and I'm gonna make 4 more of these, and then they'll be off to Lockmania for his Christmas series. So check that out, and take care, you all. Be safe.